Animals and Plants Under Stress from Radiation. Since its foundation in 1993, the World Foundation for Natural Science has informed the world about the effects of EMF, microwave and mobile phone radiation. If you're familiar with our publications, you already know a lot about the dangers to human health from electromagnetic radiation, and also about the effects on bees. With this video and corresponding article, we now also inform you about the effects on other animals and on plants. It is important to know that all the studies presented have been carried out with radiation levels below the applicable threshold value for Germany, the United Kingdom, the United States, Canada, and many other countries that follow the ICNIRP guidelines. We start first with mammals. In the early 1990s, Dr. Leif Selfall, a researcher at Lund University in Sweden, conducted studies on how to carry pharmaceutical drugs across the blood-brain barrier on rats, but his experiments failed. However, he accidentally succeeded when he found albumin had crossed the barrier into the brains of the rats. How? He'd left his mobile phone switched on beside the rats. 2 hours of irradiation with mobile phones below the ICNIRP guidelines causes the blood-brain barrier to become deactivated. Long-term experiments on mice and rats show that infertility occurs within only 3 generations. The 4th generation will have no children. Malignant tumours were found in rats when irradiated for over 2 years. This fact was publicised by the US National Toxicology Programme and the Ramazzini studies. Publications on animal breeding show an increase in cases of cataracts in cattle and increases in miscarriages, twin births and infertility in pigs, all after installation of mobile phone transmitters in their immediate vicinity. Let us turn to the birds. Robins can no longer orient themselves by the Earth's magnetic field when they are irradiated with radio signals. So not only is it mobile phone radiation that's dangerous for birds, radio frequencies are too. There are also studies on fertility in birds. As early as 1984, Dr. Varga at the University of Heidelberg showed that chicken embryos still in the egg die or show deformities as a result of irradiation from mobile phones. In Spain and Belgium, there were studies on storks and sparrows between 2005 and 2007. The result, breeding success is lower the closer birds are to mobile phone transmitters, and fewer individual birds are sighted where there is a lot of radiation. There are more studies on amphibians and reptiles, which you can read about in our article. Among insects, I would like to start with studies on honeybees. It is generally known that honeybees, just like birds, whales, dolphins, and ungulates, orient themselves by the Earth's magnetic field. Bees also use natural electromagnetic fields for communication and are therefore extremely sensitive to technical radiation. The well-known bee scientist Daniel Favre found that bees, when irradiated by a mobile phone, show a behaviour called worker bee piping, which they normally only use in dangerous situations. Bees also display the same piping behaviour on New Year's Eve, when everyone sends New Year's greetings to each other over the wireless network. This overload of the wireless network seems to change the Earth's magnetic field in some way, so that the bees display the worker bee piping behaviour not only when it is New Year's Eve in their time zone, but also when it's New Year's Eve in other time zones, several thousand kilometres away. Further studies on honeybees show that bees under irradiation take longer to find their way back to the hive. As a result, less food is stored, there is less breeding, and colonies become smaller. The composition of the bee's lymph gland changes greatly under irradiation, which indicates stress. And in 2019, it was found that 40% of queen bees die in the pupal stage during development when irradiated. Furthermore, it's been demonstrated for ants that they lose their memory and sense of smell under irradiation, and an ant colony can perish within 1 week when irradiated by mobile phone frequencies. And in fruit flies, there are findings that the ovaries are smaller in irradiated individuals. In a 2016 field trial in Greece, conducted around several mobile phone transmitter masts, the entire insect population of pollinators was studied. The closer you got to the mast, the fewer insects there were. In a 2020 review summarizing the current state of science, the outcome is as follows. The results show that EMF could have a serious impact on the vitality of insect populations. In some experiments, it was found that despite low levels of exposure to transmitters, harmful effects occurred after several months. Field strengths 100 times below the ICNIRP limits could already have effects. When planning the expansion of mobile networks, insect habitats should be protected from high-intensity EMF they will be exposed to. Now we move on to the trees. Hundreds of cases of damage to trees located in the radiation cone of a mobile phone transmitter have been documented. The tree leaves start to turn brown in the middle of summer and fall off. Alan Vian's 2016 analysis of 60 studies on radish, tomatoes, beans, tobacco, lentils, corn, roses, hibiscus, and other plants shows there were numerous adverse effects on the metabolism of the cells, more frequent abnormal cell division, 6 times more genetic damage, inhibition of seed germination in half the cases, as well as reduced growth, height, weight of plants, and fruits in the order of up to 60% compared to non-irradiated plants. Now we come to the big question. How will 5G radiation affect animals and plants? To answer this question, we need to look at 5G frequencies first. You need to know that every radio frequency has a specific wavelength. And to receive a frequency optimally with an antenna, the antenna must be exactly as long as the wavelength. Then it begins to resonate, exactly like a tuning fork. The previous mobile frequencies, first to fourth generation, use frequencies between 0.7 and 2.6 GHz, which correspond to wavelengths of about 40 to 12 centimeters. At the moment, frequencies of up to 3.6 GHz are used for 5G. In the later stages of expansion, however, frequencies of around 30 GHz will also be used, and there is even talk of using frequencies of up to 100 GHz. These frequencies have wavelengths of 12 to 0.3 centimeters, which is why they are also called millimeter waves. What animals are there of this size? Bees and other insects. This means that the wings, antenna, hair, and limbs of insects are optimal antenna for 5G millimeter waves. They will absorb significantly more radiation energy than at lower frequencies. So much for the 5G frequencies. The second important point about 5G is that of data modulation. The frequency of the mobile radio signal is only the so-called carrier wave. The data must now be modulated onto this wave, carried on it like a backpack, and there are several methods for this, which can then also look like this. Depending on the data being transmitted, there are constant changes in this modulation. However, it has now been discovered that modulated signals are significantly more harmful than the pure carrier frequency. It is assumed that with a continuous, constant signal as a carrier frequency, the body can form defense mechanisms to keep the damage within limits. If, however, the signal changes every second, the body has no chance to adapt in any way and significantly stronger damage occurs. The increase in radiation exposure due to new frequencies and new modulation techniques for 5G, especially in an area where insects react much more sensitively, will also lead to more harmful effects on animals and plants that we cannot even begin to estimate at this point. Why does technical EMF radiation, especially mobile phone radiation, have such a harmful effect on living creatures? Perception and orientation disorders occur when animals are sensitive to EMF radiation. Resonance effects occur, where parts of the body begin to resonate. Heating of the body can occur. And because the nervous system also works with electromagnetic charges and impulses, there can be disturbances and overstimulation of the nervous system and cell communication. This can, for example, lead to the opening of the blood-brain barrier or the cellular calcium channels, which in turn can lead to oxidative stress, free radical promotion, and subsequently also to DNA damage. Especially against the background of insect mortality and the extinction of more and more species, it's important to take a closer look at the effects of technical radiation on nature, especially the combination of other harmful effects such as pesticides, genetic engineering, habitat destruction, light pollution and diseases in combination with technical radiation. This can result in much greater harm because key mechanisms such as orientation, communication and metabolic processes are disturbed by this man-made radiation. And exactly for this reason, the habitat of animals and plants must be kept free of EMF radiation. Animals also need areas that are free of mobile phone radiation in order to regenerate and live undisturbed. Support the World Foundation for Natural Science and share your knowledge with your fellow human beings. Below this video, you will find a link to an article where you can read more details about this topic. There you will also find answers to why this issue is so rarely reported and a list of all sources used.